Here we go then. It's time to race in Mexico City, a place which gave Honda their first ever victory back in 1965. American Richie Ginther won from third on the grid. And what of the Honda-powered cars this year? Well, Red Bull have been going strong here in recent seasons, so can they keep that record going today?
At 2,285 metres above sea level, the thin air of the Autódromo Hermanos Rodríguez poses a unique challenge, not just to a driver's skill, but to the efficiency of their engines as well. 17 corners make up a lap of this 2.6-mile circuit, and you can expect incredible speeds in excess of 220 miles per hour. And overtaking too, into the hard braking zones of turns 1 and turn 4.
Alongside me once again for coverage of today's race, it's none other than the great Anthony Davidson.
Let's talk about the Grim Reaper.
That was a solid result in their last race. Can they keep that momentum going this weekend?
It's always nice to come into a Grand Prix weekend on a high, but your expectations are based much more on your practice and qualifying runs, so it's the momentum from those sessions that they'll be hoping to carry into the race today.
Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's race. Charles Leclerc lines up on pole position, and Lando Norris lines up alongside. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Hamilton, Sainz, Pierre Gasly and Verstappen, Ricciardo, Perez, Fernando Alonso and Yuki Tsunoda, Ocon, Stroll, Mick Schumacher, and Latifi, Bottas, Giovinazzi, and Guan Yu Zhou, and Nikita Mazepin. Russell, they'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty, and the Grim Reaper. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
race over, take care of the car on the way in.
It's a performance to be proud of from our Mexico City Grand Prix winners. Tell me, Ant, how did they manage to achieve this win?
Well, they certainly stood out as a driver with tons of confidence on the track. I think their ability to keep their cool, even during some of the more hectic parts of the race, meant they were able to capitalise on the mistakes of other drivers, giving them the opportunity to make their way to the top spot with ease.
Here come our winners now. A thrilling race and a tremendous effort by Ferrari. Their history is well known, so it's no surprise to fans the world over to see them come out on top once again. That lead at the top of the table has shrunk somewhat today. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for driver of the day?
I have to give it to the Grim Reaper. They did a great job at getting the most out of their tyres without losing pace, something that's a very handy skill to have in modern-day Formula One.
It's another clear win for Mercedes as they managed to secure the Constructors' title. An incredible performance for the whole team. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. And with that, we wrap up another weekend of motorsport. But with more races lined up, be sure to join us when we come back with more Formula One.
The fans really seem to enjoy that. You made it look easy. How do you feel these grid penalties are affecting the sport? Are you happy with your performance today? Great. Well, that's everything.
Our new parts have completed without issue. They'll be on the car ready for the next race weekend.